long as they agree and there's an amount agreed between them that the man will pay a woman certain amount. This is how mota is done.
Dowry. Say dowry. If I don't, dowry.
Okay, call it dowry. Call it dowry.
What do you do when you marry a normal girl?
No, that's proper.
That's proper.
No, no, it is.
I'll tell you why it's proper. Because they intend to stay together for the rest of
their lives. And you look, yeah. and you believe you can marry with the intention of divorce?
No.
You don't marry with the intention of divorce? Do Sunni scholars say that?
No.
You're
going to talk about Mithyar?
Nope.
No.
Intent? No. No one talk about me. I made the claim, some Sunni scholars believe that you can marry with the intention of divorce.
Okay. Without telling the other person.
Without telling the girl. Okay.
Some so-called Sunni scholars believe that you can have a woman have a woman having a bath, the Zahiri. Some of the Zahiri scholars. I can put you out, Sunni so-called, the ones you get. One guy, some idiot somewhere in the middle of nowhere, he has said something stupid. Your Sunni scholars are saying this. Your Sunni scholars are saying this.
I agree. Come on, he's saying it's a short opinion. You know, now watch this. You said majority about, be fair, you just accused the majority and that was a lie, Adnan. Come on a minute, let me finish.
If I don't prove this.
Majority Mujtahideen.
If I don't prove this. Wait,
majority Mujtahideen.
If I don't prove this, what I said.
Take it back.
Then I'm guilty.
Take it back.
I'm guilty. I'll take it back.
No problem. Now let me prove my point.
Okay. Do you want to have a discussion on this on a separate day? Muta. And I'll bring all the sources. I'll bring all the aqwal of your Mujtahideen.
Yes. Do you
understand? Okay, Raza, do you understand it needs research? Require research.
Yeah. No, you made a claim, not me.
Okay. I'm saying I'm going to stand by my claim.
That's fine.
I, what did I mention? Mota is what? Nobody. No. Dowry is there. The rakam, you know, the amount we have to agree on.
No.
It could be in kind. It could be anything. It could be a bag of wheat.
No witnesses.
Okay, wait. Yeah, no witnesses.
The
no.
Is the witness the marriage.
Wait, Yaqeen. I'm talking
about. You're playing games.
Why am I playing games?
You when know
I'm
why?
When I'm saying I'm going to prove it. If I don't prove it, if I don't bring the reports and acquire of the, your scholars, then I'm guilty. But you know what I'm talking about. You know how this is how it's done. This is how it's done in Pakistan. This is how it's done
in Pakistan. In Pakistan, she's hardly even doing what we see as a taboo. You don't even know your thing, bro. Hold on. Wait. I'm Pakistani. Majority Pakistani Shias don't even touch it. You know why? Because they're influenced by Sunnis. They consider it bad. What are you talking about? You don't even know Pakistani culture.
I don't blame
you. So then why did you say Pakistanis do it?
That's why.
You see, you don't know your thing, bro.
Pakistanis
you don't know it.
Do it.
Pakistanis hardly do it.
Okay. So the Pakistanis do it.
Oh, very smart, Adnan. Very smart.
Pakistani do it.
Very intellectual. That's fine.
In Pakistan, Iran.
Okay, now go around.
Pakistan, Iran, Lebanon.
Majority scholars, but I leave you guys. Anyway.
The majority.
Syria.
Practice it.
The majority practice it the way I described it, yes.
Cool, that's fine. That's fine.
And so obviously you know it's about upon me to prove
you
it.
Obviously know about our community.
Now,
Leave it. That's fine. Leave it at that.
If that is true, what I stated, then what? No, look.
Let's qualify. You can qualify that.
Look,
let's move forward.
For me, the Shias, they have this view. Okay.
Exactly. If you had said that, I would have been. No, but it's because when you try to misrepresent,
they want to do it. It's up to them.
No, it's not about doing it. It's about. Listen. This is a hypothetical.
The Shias.
Misinformation. Anyway,
wait. Which claim are you saying is misinformation?
About the Wali one, is that the majority do say this as well?
Pakistanis don't even do it. And
if
saying,
I bring,
that's how I know.
If I bring evidence,
Pakistanis do
if
what
I bring evidence that your major scholar, no, I'm not talking about
majority.
Have you researched this topic already?
Yes, I have.
Okay, so why do you not have the
I don't have resources with me here. Okay, I don't have my laptop.
So you asked me for references. Why do you expect me to have?
No.
That's fine.
That's what I'm saying. You want to have a discussion on this? Let's meet another day. I'll bring all my sources on Mota and why I'm saying what I'm saying. Sorry? No, we've been talking about Mota for the last 2 hours. For some reason, Mota is a very
No, but it's because you keep trying it. Wallahi, Mota's not a big issue for me. But because you keep doing misrepresentation, I have to keep. I'm going to say the last thing. Please just close Mota. Adnan, do you agree?
Okay.
Can we close Mota, please? I know people are probably tired of hearing it.
Now, do you want to talk about it another time?
No.
The claim you made, you can say. There we go, here's another one.
I want you to tell me one thing. Are there any Shia scholars who describe Mota as I have?
The Wali thing, yeah. Some scholars disagree about the Wali.
Okay.
Like Hanafis.
Wali is one thing, okay. What about no witnesses?
In Shia school, you don't need witnesses for normal marriage. Okay. You don't need witnesses
for normal
marriage.
I'm right about it. Okay.
The witnesses
so no imam. No imam is required.
What is imam required in permanent marriage?
Sorry.
Is imam required in permanent marriage?
Yes.
An imam is required in permanent marriage.
But khutbah, you need proper ceremony.
Hold on. If you can read Arabic and the girl can read Arabic, you need the imam. Think about what you're saying.
No, khutbah is the pillar. Is the rukn of nikah. No, it doesn't have to be an imam to read it. When I say imam, you know exactly what I mean. Yeah.
Can you and the girl recite herself?
Yes.
So why is, what are you talking about? So what are you talking about,
Adnan? Wait. As long as there are two witnesses.
That's we discussed already.
As long as there are two witnesses and mahar has been agreed upon and this khutbah masnoona, nikah is done. That's nikah.
In the Hanafi, what is this? In the Hanafi school, do you need witnesses?
I'm not a Hanafi, so I
can't. I asked you the question.
Okay, ask the Hanafi.
You're in the past, you know Hanafi is more than me.
I'm Salafi.
Intellectual honesty.
I'm Salafi.
You know Hanafi position.
Okay, wait.
What is it?
Now.
You see?
In Hanafi position.
The Hanafi position is that you don't need witnesses. How do you feel?
No, Wali.
No, Wali.
Wali.
So you need witnesses?
I know. But I'm not Hanafi.
I never asked if you are. I'm not Hanafi position.
Okay.
So, you saw it. It doesn't work. It don't work like that.
Don't worry about conditions. I'm not Hanafi. I can't defend
them. I never said defend them.
I am not.
I'm trying to show you that the issue of witnesses.
No. Wait. Wali. The issue is the Wali.
And Hanafis have the same thing?
So, no problem. As a man. Not for Muta. Hanafis don't believe in Muta.
But they believe in marriage?
Yeah. So that's fine. So it's a permanent marriage. It's a permanent marriage.
So the issue is about.
There is no 10 minutes. There's no 10 minutes or one day or 10 days.
Okay, you know what there is though? Let me tell you what there is.
Okay, wait.
Let me tell you what there is.
I was describing it and I asked you. But you said Wali, there's an issue. No problem. Okay.
Majority. No, you said majority.
Wali. Witnesses, no witnesses required. Well, yes?
Even impermanent. Even impermanent.
Okay.
Even though you're trying to make Muta sound different.
Wait. Even I'm telling you why it's different. I'm going to explain why it's different. No witnesses.
Okay.
No khutbah masnoona or no imam to recite or no one to recite.
You don't need the imam to recite them as well.
Okay. Now what's left? What's left? Yeah, wait. What's
Hanafi
left?
Claim. Wait. Come forward and come talk then. Don't give your phone, come forward.
Wait.
MashaAllah.
Wait.
It's another guy.
Raza. So what's, brother, you, allow it, leave it. There's a lot I can do and I can say. I can continue our discussion on Hanafi fiqh for another day, no problem. We're not going to do that. I'm trying to get to the bottom of it. So what's left with Muta now? One man and one woman, right? One man and one woman, they can both agree with each other. Okay, no guardian, no. I'm claiming that according to majority, no guardian needed. No guardian. I'm claiming.
Majority of fuqaha.
Yeah. Majority of the Shia.
No, you said fuqaha.
Generally.
No. Who makes the religion? The fuqaha or us?
You said scholars.
Let me finish my claim and then you can come back.
Wow.
Okay, so what's left is now one girl and one man, okay? They can now both agree behind the backs of the families that we have now agreed to spend 10 minutes, 1 hour, or 10 hours, or 10 days together for this amount. The family doesn't have to know, the mother doesn't have to know, the girl in particular, and the father doesn't have to know. This is Muta. And if I have lied, please correct me. If I have lied on the issue of Wali, you're disputing it. I'm saying the majority of the Shia scholars have already said you don't need Wali. Okay, and I'll give you evidence where they've said it, how they've said it. If that's the case, then it's only one man, one woman with them. They can do what they want.
Okay, however long they want. Now, again, I don't read, you keep doing it, but I don't want to go to Muta, but you keep forcing me. If a Sunni, who's a Hanafi, who's a man, goes to a woman, she runs away from home, she recites, them two recite the nikah by themselves.
No, they can't.
You said they could earlier on.
You need witnesses.
No problem, because they have the shuruut of witnesses.
Yeah.
And they get two witnesses, and they don't tell their family, and they recite the nikah. Yeah. Is it valid?
Yes, with two witnesses, yes. Because it's permanent nikah. It's not 10 minutes.
That's fine.
It's not 10 minutes.
Listen.
There's a difference.
Let me finish.
I don't want to use the wrong language.
Let me finish.
It's not 10 minutes. It's a bond for the
life. But guess what? They hidden on it. They hid it.
From everybody or just
the
parents?
Listen.
Apart from the two witnesses there, so how do they?
Apart from the two.
It's witnesses.
Don't have to.
Two
is minimum. Two is minimum. There can be a ceremony.
It's the same thing. Listen,
Adnan.
It's a
marriage.
But Muta for us is a marriage, don't you know?
Yes, but it's 10 minutes. You agree it's 10 minutes?
Why are you giving the extreme scenario?
Okay. It can be 1 hour.
1 minute.
Is it valid?
What's
1 hour?
What's worse, you know? What's worse? Someone marries a girl and a boy, and they marry each other for a time period, and they both know what's going on. Is that worse? And you're actually saying Islamically, Quranically, by Sunnah, from our standards, it's agreed. And there's dispute amongst people as well. Or is this worse? Ibn Hajr says, Iyad said, they unanimously agreed that the condition of invalidity is to openly disclose the condition of time. So if he intends during the act to separate after a period, his marriage is valid. Only Al-Uza'i disagreed.
Okay.
So that means the majority of Sunni scholars said what, according to Ibn Hajar, according to Iyad, that you can marry with the intention of divorce.
I am saying it's haram. I'm telling
you're
you.
You're no one. Ibn Hajar, speak okay, okay, you're no one.
You don't know what Ibn Hajar is saying. You don't know. No.
Don't tell
listen,
me you say.
I can pull out something from one of the sources and read a quote and say Ibn Hajar is saying.
Okay, now he said.
Okay,
I'll give you an example. I'll take my context.
I'll give you an example.
Let me finish my words. No, I'll let you speak. I'll let you speak, Adnan. You can't keep going too many.
I'll give you an example.
No.
Why I don't
accept it? You spent an hour trying to make a false narrative of Mutar. Now I'm going to give you a real narrative which I can substantiate. Imam Nawawi said. Al Qadi said.
So you're saying 10 minutes is fine?
In extra, if you want to play in that game, you should not work.
It's fine, that's fine.
Okay. Hold on, bro, you won the argument.
Okay. No, but that's how it is.
He wants to give the most extreme example. Imam Nawawi now, Ibn Hajar, Imam Nawawi.
But that's not most extreme.
That is the most extreme. No, imagine 10 minutes, bro.
If people are.
If all
people want is sexual gratification.
Well, you need the father's permission according to us.
But all you need is 10 minutes in some cases.
Maybe 10 minutes, that's fine. But what I'm trying to say to you is that you need the father's permission.
Sorry?
You need the father's permission. Why are you making
No, you don't need
Al-Qadi said. Imam Nawawi said this. Imam Nawawi said. Qadi again.
I'm not accepting any of this.
Why?
All of this is out of context.
Let me go.
All of this You can only deceive the Shia masses. Not me.
And what will you do in a minute?
I said, if I'm a liar, go and check. I'm asking the Shia brothers and sisters, go and check your sources. What I said, if it's true, then think. If it's not true, then I'm a liar.
I'm a liar. He hasn't brought source yet. He said, check it. Okay.
Check it.
What source have you brought?
I'm lying.
Majority. Imam Nawawi says.
Okay. Let's establish a day. Next Sunday, I'm
lying. I know you're impressed with Mutar. Do a video. Showing the video.
Listen to me.
No, that's wrong what you've done. Just show the clips. Next Sunday,
I'm going to bring my sources on Mutar.
Majority of Mujtahideen. Majority of Mujtahideen says, Al-Alad Wula Wali.
I'm saying majority of the Shia scholars.
You see?
You said majority
of the Shia scholars. Who talks about halal haram?
How many mujtahideen do you have?
Hundreds.
Hundreds of mujtahideen.
From the Muqaddimun to now, yeah.
Okay.
Thousands.
So you say majority?
If I show the majority of the Shia scholars.
Majority, 50%,
60%, 70%.
It's a very difficult
claim. So why do you make the claim then?
I'm standing
by. Intellectually, what you could have said was, some Shia scholars said you need the wali.
No,
some said you don't. I would have been like, that's true. But instead he said the majority and he flopped.
I'll give you an example of what I mean by majority. Okay, majority of the Sunnis believe Mut'ah is haram. Yes? There are some, like you gave an example of Abdullah bin Abbas. He allowed it in extreme circumstances, like pig meat is allowed in extreme circumstances.
Okay,
he allowed it like that. So majority, I'm saying, now you can turn around and say, how do you know majority? No, it's not the wrong claim. Because I'm making a similar claim about the Shia school. That this is how do we know?
Okay, yeah. Is that how you talk again?
Sorry?
Not
again,
but
we had a long discussion.
Yeah, we had it. That's right. Okay, just my last statement.
Late.
Okay, just last statement. No, we said about Ayad. Let me mention this again.
What are you talking about, Misyar?
No, I've mentioned that marriage with the intention of divorce. Watch this. Al Qadi said they unanimously agreed that whoever contracts a permanent marriage, while his intention is to stay with her only for a period of time, when he intends, and then his marriage is collecting halal, and this is not muta. The muta he's trying to say. You can marry with the intention to divorce, just divorce her afterwards. Do your thing and divorce her. That's allowed. But Mutah's not allowed. That's what God
is. I'll tell you.
I'm saying this is haram.
I'm saying majority. I'm again making a claim now. Listen to my claim now.
They unanimously
I'm saying
agree.
The majority of our scholars. And I'm saying 99%. 99% of our scholars, Ahl Sunnah, 99, Shafi, Maliki, Hanbali, and Salafi, all of them are unanimous that knowingly getting married to a woman when you have an intention to divorce. It's haram. Haram. I'm telling you, the majority. I said four schools and the Salafi school.
I showed Ibn Hajar and Nawawi. What did you show?
I made a claim. Ask me to prove it.
We'll prove it later.
Okay.
Prove it later.
Ask
I
me
showed
to prove
Nawawi.
It. I made a claim.
Show it. I showed Nawawi.
And I'm condemning it. You will condemn Mutah. Go on, condemn Mutah.
I believe in it.
Why we don't believe in it. Why are you trying? Just to prove Mutah. Just to make Mutah reasonable. Why are you throwing these things?
Because you're trying it with me, so you can try it back.
No, I'm not. I'm saying this is nothing like Mutah. Even if it's
this is worse. You know why it's worse? It's worse. Because it's Khiyana. You marry with the intention to divorce.
I'll tell you why.
And with Mutah, you know what you're on.
I'll tell you. I'll tell you why it's not worse. Wait, brothers, I'll tell you why it's not worse. Let's assume for argument's sake, I'd like to see territory. Okay, I'm saying it's not worse. I'll tell you why. There's a man. Can you let me finish?
Let's go back to me.
Let's assume this position is correct and it's the majority Sunni position. Let's assume, for argument's sake, no problem. I'm saying this is worse. This is not worse than Mutah. I'll tell you why. In this case, there's a man who has an intention to divorce a woman, and only he knows about this intention. In the marriage, the entire family is involved. Listen, yeah. You will understand when I'm finished. The girl, as far as the girl knows, she knows that she is getting married permanently. This is a man she likes. The family gets involved. The father knows. The mother knows. The aunts know. The cousins know. There's a celebration. They send the girl away with the guy who has a very bad intention inside, who has not expressed his intention to the family. No one knows about his intention. Only he knows in his heart, right? What the scholars say, that technically the nikah is valid. What the man is doing is haram. It is haram for him to do that. Well, he cannot do that. Wait. Let me finish. It's haram for him. Now, where is the comparison between this situation where there's a celebration, girl has been married off, the family knows, and the other situation where the father doesn't know, the mother doesn't know, no one knows. Girl meets a guy. She meets a man. They go to a hotel. They do muta. Wait. Wait. I'm giving you a scenario.
Amazing.
I'm giving you. They go to a hotel. They spend 10 minutes, 1 hour, 10 hours, whatever, 10 days together. And the girl goes back home. I was on a holiday. I went to college.
Okay,
I was away on a trip with the college. Okay. Now. Where is the difference?
Where is the comparison?
Where is the comparison? You better stop Mutah. Seriously. You better stop Mutah because it's getting worse.
Thank you, Adnan. Thank you for
it's getting worse.
Because we're really like very...
Yeah, you can't defend Mutah.
But you can defend this. Okay, that's fine.
No, I'm not defending this. I'm saying it's haram.
Okay, what's this?
I'm saying it's haram.
I mentioned...
Bring me one scholar who said... Who said? No. What I want to know... Bring me one Sunni scholar. One Sunni scholar who said it is allowed for a man to intend to divorce a woman and get married to her. One. No, they're not saying that. They're saying the nikah is technically valid. But the man, what the man is doing, he's hiding his intention. It's haram.
But the marriage is valid.
So we don't believe in this. So try not to justify Mutah by bringing shahs.
You believe it's allowed. The act itself is allowed. You believe the act is allowed, but the marriage is halal.
No, I don't believe that.
No, I'm not going to use that language. We're
not attracting anyone. So the point is, even if this was true, okay. Yeah, no, I don't believe in this. I'm telling you, I'm Salafi.
I'm just quoting.
I know. I don't know any Shafi, Maliki, Hanbali. I read the works.
I read the works.
They don't believe in this. This is desperation. This is desperation on your part to try to bring things from our sources, which you don't believe in, and impose them on us to somehow make Mutah look acceptable.
Why are you relying on the four schools to justify your position?
I said I'm Salafi.
If we quote the other four schools, none of
the Sunni schools believe that it is allowed for a man to intend woman to a divorce and then get married.
It's haram.
You're not understanding.
Okay, you're being
from a woman's perspective, a girl. Who was married properly to a man. No one knows what's inside the man. By the apparent, the marriage is valid. Now, for the man, it is haram. It is why? Because he had a bad intention. Now, in Mutah, how can the marriage for the girl? How is it haram for her? How is it haram for the girl? For the guy to get married to a girl like that is haram. For the girl, it is a valid wedding. So the point is, Mutah, no celebration. How is this straw man? No celebration, no witnesses, no third party, no third person. two people get together, a girl and a man. They agree with each other. We're going to spend time together. And they agree to money. They agree to
Mahan.
No, wait. Don't. Please.
This is the kind of stuff. But this kind of conversation you have, this kind of conversation attracts me. As a wise man, this attracts me.
So what conversation do you have?
You know what I'm talking about. Allah wa alim knows our hearts. This attracts that.
Okay, let's finish that.
No, but it's not even important.
I don't know.
You can speak as many.